So we just looked at the n8n cloud platform, which was our first option of setting up n8n or how to use n8n. The second option that I wanted to tell you was how you can install it on your own local machine. And for own installation or own setup, you have multiple options again. So the first option that is there is using the Docker image, which is already available over there. And if you don't understand what Docker is, I'm going to talk about the step-by-step process. You don't need to get technical into what is Docker, what are containers. So we are not going to talk about that stuff. We'll just skip the entire techie stuff. Just follow certain steps. And as I said, this option is more suitable for people who are more technical in nature. You need to have some sort of technical understanding, but if you follow along the steps over here, you can definitely install the n8n on your own local machine for further testing. If you want to have some sort of, you know, production ready automation workflows, then of course you need to understand how you can set up as a server and install n8n over there. You need to be a bit technical in nature in order to follow this path where you would have more control of data. You don't need to pay for subscription that is there because they are managing your instance. So now you are going to manage your instance. So that hassle of management of the server, maintenance of the server, maintenance of the configuration of n8n lies on you now. So that's why you don't end up paying, but you end up paying on your own time or the technical skills that you have. If you don't have that, you are beginner, better start with the n8n cloud platform. Get a hang of it. Once you are building automation workflows, you want to scale and you are not ready to pay the fee that they are charging, then come back and choose one of the installation options that I'm going to demonstrate to you. Before going into the practical screen share step-by-step process of installing n8n, let's look at some of the concepts or some of the basic differences that exist in these couple of options which are there. The first option is using the Docker image which is available. This is ideal for production use cases where you have to deploy your automation in production. That means those automation would be running your businesses. It is ideal for those complex and heavy duty automation workflows which processes large amount of data and require scaling, horizontal scaling or vertical scaling. Hence, it is more suitable for the deployments which are there in cloud, maybe DigitalOcean, AWS, GCP or Azure. And because it runs inside a lightweight secure container, it isolates itself from the other software that are running on the server or the machine, and hence more suited for the production environments. The second option is using on a developer machine for, you know, testing purposes or development purposes, which is more like a local machine to you. As I'm using my system, I'm going to install it and show you how to install it on a local machine. So this will be my machine, although I'm going to demonstrate both the approaches of using the Docker image as well as the local instance, which is more like a local machine where I'll be using something called NPM. If you're not familiar with Node.js, so NPM is Node Package Manager. I'm going to use that to have a Node.js version of n8n installed on a local developer machine, which is my machine over here. And this kind of setup is ideal for custom integrations, or if you want more control, or if this is just a developer environment where you want to build your workflows, test them out in a local setup, then promote it to a production, which could be a cloud server where you are hosting your Docker image kind of installation. And finally, third option was also available a couple of years ago, which was more like a desktop app. That app is no longer supported officially, so we are not going to cover that aspect of it. So now let's get onto the screen share and see how the first installation option looks like. And I'm going to reverse the order of it. First, I'm going to set up the Node.js version, which is more like using the NPM to install the n8n instance on my local machine. Then we are going to talk about the Docker image. All right, you can see that I'm on the documentation page of n8n website, and I'm going to follow this so that you can have a reference to yourself as well to follow along these steps in case you have missed, you want to go back and see what the documentation was. Over here, you can see this is a self-hosting option for n8n, and here the options are available that you can install n8n on any platform using NPM or Docker, and we can follow the guide which is available. So right now what we are going to do is we are going to click on the NPM version of it, and we are going to just follow along whatever this guide suggests. So over here, you can see that it is telling us the quickest way to get started is on your own local machine, and you must have Node.js installed. So what I'm going to do is click on Node.js. So I have uninstalled everything on my local machine. I'm going to click on this Node.js download button. It is going to like download it. It is right now downloading on my local machine. So we are going to first install Node.js on my local machine. I had it uninstalled just to demonstrate the entire process over here, so that if you are starting from scratch, I am also starting from scratch. All right, so it has downloaded on my downloads folder. I'll click on it so that I can start installing. So you can see it is going to install the 22.14 version of it on my this user path. And then I'll click on continue. I accept the license, agree. Then we click on the install. It's asking for the password. So it is installing now. All right. So the NPM, you can see the NPM Node Package Manager version is also installed, as well as Node.js installed. Since this is installed now, we can open up the terminal. I'm using the MacBook, so I'm going to talk about the terminal. You can open the command line option, and once you have the installation on your Windows machine, you would be able to access the NPM as well as Node. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to quickly open up my terminal. So here you can see the terminal is opened over here, and first option that we can do is we can say that node-v. So it should tell us that a Node.js version is installed, and you can see that whatever version we installed, that version of 22.14 is being shown over here. Same goes with npm. So I'll write npm-v, it is going to show me the version. So you can see that 11.2 version of npm is also installed. So now that we have basic prerequisites set up on our local machine, let's get to the next step of it. So now I'll go back and I'll go back to the documentation over here. So now you can see that the first option, it is letting us try n8n without installation. You can issue the command npx, which is more like node package executor. So we had npm, which is node package manager. We have npx, where you can use npx n8n to just try it out. It is not going to install it. It is just going to let you try out the n8n, but we are not going to do that. We are going to install the n8n on our machine for global users, like all the users on my machine. So I'm going to copy paste this command, npm install n8n/g. So let me go back to my terminal. And you'll see quickly it will start installing the n8n on our local machine. All right, the installation process has started. So now you can see that it has successfully installed on our local machine. We are going to go back onto the documentation and see what's the next step. Now you can see that after installation, it is asking us to just issue this command n8n start. So what I'm going to do is n8n start. Now it says that it is going to open up my browser. I can press O to open up my browser. And there you go, n8n is up and running on your local machine. You can see this localhost :5678 as setup. So the first time it is setup that we have to do, we have to set up our own user. So I'm going to like specify my email over here. So here I can specify a personal email as well. I'm going to specify my name and then password. And I can select this checkbox if I want to receive security and product updates. I'll just skip that. I'll click on next. And there you go. Again, that kind of form that we saw in the cloud version setup, this is also over here. I can specify, you know, what the company is. I'm the business owner. Who will your automation mainly be? So it will be like myself. How big is your company? It's like less than 20 people. How did you hear about us? Maybe again, Google. So again, I click on it. So what this form is telling us, that I can get some of the paid features which are available for free, and that is for forever, by activating my instance that I have installed and receiving a license key. So these features are like workflow history, and we are going to talk about these features, advanced debugging, execution search and tagging, as well as folders concept. All this we are going to get by receiving a license key over email that I have mentioned. So what I'll do is send me a free license key so that I can set up and receive free updates. And you can see that our local instance is up and running of n8n ready to start automating our workflows. So the last step in this video would be to go over to my inbox. They must have already sent me the license key. As you can see, I have opened up my email and the license key is over here. I'm going to just copy it and I'm going to come back on my local instance of n8n. And as you can see, your license key is on the way. We can check the email and I need to go over here, which is like my name over here. You can click on the settings. And then over here, you can see you can unlock some of the paid features which are there forever. So on this screen, I can click on this enter activation key button and it will open up a pop-up where I can paste the activation key or license key that I have received in my email. If I click on the activate, and you can see that my n8n version, which is locally installed on my machine, is now successfully registered as a community edition, and a lot of paid features which are there are unlocked in this instance. So before ending this lesson, I wanted to come back on the documentation and show you how you can update the n8n version which is installed locally or move to a specific version of it. So you can see at the bottom of this page which we followed, there is this command npm update /g n8n. So this is going to update to the latest stable version of n8n. Now you also see that there is another one which is like @next. So @n8n is being used to specify a specific version that you want to download or install on your local machine. So you can see over here that if I want n8n version 0.126.1, I have to specify npm install -g n8n @0.126.1. So this is going to install this specific version. And what n8n does is it maintains two versions. One is the stable release. So if you're not specifying anything like @ or anything, it is going to install the most up-to-date stable version of n8n. However, if you specify a particular version, it will install the particular version. But then there is this next thing. Next thing is that a version has been released, more like an alpha or beta version that you can also install, but the guarantee of stability is not there because that is just alpha or a beta version. So use that version only if you really want to test out or develop on some of the latest features which are not there in your stable build. And later in this lesson, we are going to come back to this interface and talk about each and every element which is there on the entire interface. Although I'm going to use my cloud version of the instance, not the local version, so that I can walk you through the entire set of features which are available on the cloud as well, which includes all the features which are there on my local copy of n8n as well. So that's how you can quickly and easily set up n8n on your local machine and start building workflows for free.